park was established in 1930, our enabling legislation says that this park was established to commemorate the colonial and revolutionary periods in American history. Jamestown is the site of the first permanent English colony, and it's really the birthplace of our representative government. The archaeological resources we have on Jamestown Island are incredibly important to our nation's history as a whole. They're the physical reminder of how people, you know, lived here on the island thousands of years ago and record the fledgling colony's beginnings, which were very tenuous in that first 10 years of existence.
Archaeology's greatest strength, arguably, is its perspective in deep time with respect to the human experience. And so we can not only chart changes in the way societies have functioned at different times, made their living, organized themselves socially and politically, but we can also do it by looking at the backdrop of the environment. And we always want to see linkages, or not, okay, between what people are doing and the context that they're working within. Jamestown Island is a perfect laboratory for understanding the relationship and the responses of human beings to their environments. There's been enough high quality work here that we have command of at least the basic story. Working simply from the studies that have been conducted on Jamestown Island, a very small island at that, we can speak about how human beings have responded to natural change, all right, over the span of 10,000 years.
Cultural resources contain a lot of information about the very long-term relationships between humans and their environment. They contain that record of how we got to where we are, and a record of how we've dealt with the environment. And as we look towards climate change adaptation moving into the future, the perspective that we're taking is that's really important information that we need going forward. How did past cultures deal with past environmental change? How did they deal with environmental variability? The past gives us some of the best examples that there are. So understanding when cultures, like, when do they recognize that stuff was really different? Like, oh, it's not going back. We need to figure out something else. Because having those examples in front of us helps us better understand where we might go.
We may see a collapse, for instance, of a civilization. And at exactly the same time, there was deterioration of the environment, became more arid or colder or both. And we want to understand if there is a connection between those two events. So there are lessons that we can draw on by looking at these correlations over deep time that have relevance to us today. Human beings have had to contend with their environmental context for a long time. And you know what? Human beings are remarkable in their ability to adapt and adjust. And that's the record we see. And what we also see there is that when they don't adapt and adjust properly, there are difficulties, often extreme difficulties. And so I think that alone is a valuable lesson for us to take away.
Jamestown really has two intersecting climate stories. One, of course, is the Jamestown colonists, the English colonists that arrived in 1607. And through the studies of tree rings, in combination with the historical documents, we know that they arrived in the middle of pretty severe drought, and that affected the starving time and many of the really difficult times that they went through in the early settlement period.
The challenges that faced these colonists were legendary, and no one had ever been quite sure why they suffered the way they did. Could it have been some aspect of the local environment that presented at least some of the challenges? We were shocked, frankly, to see that Not only was there a severe drought, timed exactly with the arrival of the English colonists here, between 1606 and 1612 specifically, but that drought was the most severe extended drought in the entire 800-year record that we had taken from these bald cypress trees.
Then the other piece is that there were Native Americans. We don't know nearly as much about what they went through and how they adjusted and adapted to those environmental changes. And as the sea level rises and starts to inundate archaeological sites from the bottom up, that's what we stand to lose. That is what is likely to go away.
Climate change will likely be detrimental to most of those archaeological resources. All the sites that are, you know, coastal sites along the rivers and waterways here, if the current model continues and the sea level does rise, they will be washed away, eroded, or inundated. But it's not just that. You know, we're seeing intense storms that come at, you know, more frequently than they had in the past. Trees are getting uprooted and dislodging archaeological components and portions of sites.
At the same time, we're starting to understand we need the information that's in those resources, but that's what we stand to lose. And Jamestown shows us that. But any place that has cultural resources likely has that set of interactions of what's going on here, who has lived here in the past, what had they lived through, what do we know about it, what don't we know about it, and how does the history of that place relate to how we've gotten to where we are, how we understand ourselves, and where might we go in the future. I know we can't preserve everything, but if we can start to understand the scale of the information that's out there and what it is we have to learn from it, then maybe we'll get a little bit further down the line. But the sense that we're losing information that we desperately need concerns me a lot.